If you ever worry that the beginning of the NCAA tournament won't deliver in terms of drama and suspense and some upsets, well, rest easy. Day one of the 2016 NCAA tournament provided just that, especially here at the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island. Four games to get us underway in the 2016 NCAA tournament, and all four games provided some drama. At the very beginning of this session, one of the blue bloods of college basketball took this court, the five-time NCAA champions, the Duke Blue Devils. They're the number four seed in the West region, and they took on their Tar Heel State brethren, the number 13 seed, the UNCW Seahawks, only the second time Duke and UNCW squaring off in their schools' histories. And it was Duke defeating UNCW by a score of 93-85. Duke actually had to come back from a six-point deficit that they had late in the first half. Brandon Ingram hit a big three-pointer for the Duke Blue Devils at the very end of the first half. That shot was the spark and the beginning of a 24-8 run for the Duke Blue Devils as Duke took control in the second half. UNCW did not go away quietly, cut Duke's lead down to five a couple of times, but Duke able to see off the Seahawks, and Duke advancing to the second round where they will take on the Yale Bulldogs, the number 12 seed in the West region, pulling off the upset, a 79-75 victory, the Ivy League champions over the Baylor Bears of the Big 12. And Yale was led by their fantastic sophomore guard, Mekhi Mason, 31 points in the contest, 17 points in the first half. Yale advancing to take on the Duke Blue Devils in the second round. And then to begin the nightcap in the South region, it was the Miami Hurricanes, the number three seed in the ACC, defeating the number 14 seed, the Buffalo Bulls, the champions of the Mid-American Conference, by a score of 79-72. Five players scoring in double figures for the Miami Hurricanes, led by their amazing guard, Angel Rodriguez. He had 24 points. And in the nightcap, the number 11 seed, the Wichita State Shockers, 2 days after winning in the first four in Dayton against the Vanderbilt Commodores, they come to Providence and pull off the upset, 65-55 over the Arizona Wildcats. The Wildcats came into this game averaging 81.2 points per game on the season. Wichita State holding Arizona to 26 points below their average. Wichita State, the best defense in the country, only allowing 59 points per game on the season, holding the Wildcats to just 55 points, including only 19 points the Wildcats scored in the first half, as Wichita State opened up a 12-point lead at halftime, and they really didn't look back. Most of the second half, the Shockers had a double-digit lead. And after the game, we had the pleasure to talk with Greg Marshall, the head coach of the Wichita State Shockers, and I asked him to begin our conversation. This was his 10th win in the NCAA tournament as a head coach. Outside of just advancing to the next round, why was win number 10 in the NCAA tournament tonight special?
Well, this is special because of the type program that we were able to win against today. So much respect for Sean and his players and his program and the way they go about their business. They've been one of the top 10 programs in the country the last 10 since he's been there. And just really, really pleased that we were able to go out and hold them to 55 and get a 10-point win. And ultimately, it's... you know, just gives us a chance now to play Miami for Sweet 16 berth, and that's what it's all about here. But we beat a good basketball team tonight, a tradition-rich program, and a friend.
How did you hold Arizona to 26 points below their average? What was the one or two key things that you wanted your defense to really key on, because they have such a multifaceted attack?
Well, we denied their post guys as best we could. We did a good job with that. They really hurt us on the offensive glass. That was the key. When you're denying like that, they get inside position. But we also were able to dig the ball out of the post. I thought our guards were really good at digging that ball out of the post. And then ultimately turning them over a few times. They had 19 turnovers to 20 baskets, which is a very good ratio.
Your front court gets overlooked and has been overlooked the past couple of years, of course, with the exploits of Baker and Van Vliet, Shaquille Morris, 7.7 rebounds, a couple of blocks as well. How is this front court in 2015-2016 evolved to be the front court that you need them to be this year?
Yeah, we do it by committee. It's not one guy. It's usually a couple of guys. And tonight we played four or five men. Bushwa Makota got some run. Rono Nerger was pretty good. Wasn't a great night for Grady, but he'll bounce back. And then our four men, a little undersized again, but we did three four men tonight. Rashard Kelly, Evan Wessel, and Marcus McDuffie, and they did a good enough job to hold the fours and fives for Arizona to, I think, six baskets.
Is there anything that Ron and Fred do that still amazes you and marvels? Is there anything that Fred and Ron do still? You've been around them for 4 years. Is there anything that they do still that still surprises you?
No, they're just simply amazing basketball players and great young men, and we're just blessed to have them in our program and so happy that they continue to just set a higher standard every time they walk out on the court. And they're just winners, and winners on the court, they're all winners off the court, they're winners in life, and I'm just blessed to be their coach.
Was there disappointment in being in the first four, and how do you turn any possible disappointment, even though you're in the NCAA tournament, into motivation?
Yeah, obviously I think we're a little better than an 11 seed, and I think that's been proven now, but that's the way it was. And once the ball's tossed up, the number in front of the team doesn't matter, and it's just about two basketball teams competing, and we're going to give it our best effort every single time. And tonight it was good enough for a win against a six seed that was probably underseeded as well, Arizona. So but you know, the committee can't get it perfect. This is the best sporting event in the world, in my opinion. And you know, we're just glad to be a part of it, and hopefully we can play well again on Saturday.
So once again, the Wichita State Shockers defeating Arizona. Wichita State now with their ninth NCAA tournament win in the past 4 years, tying Michigan State and Wisconsin for the second most NCAA tournament wins in the past 4 years. Only the Duke Blue Devils with more NCAA tournament wins in the past 4 years. Wichita State will play here on Saturday, the first game here in Providence. Wichita State will take on the Miami Hurricanes in game one of two here in Providence. That game will start at 12:10 Eastern time, and the game after that will be the Yale Bulldogs against the Duke Blue Devils. That game scheduled for a 2:40 start. The winner of the Duke Yale game will head to Anaheim, California, and the Sweet 16 in the West region. The winner of the game between Wichita State and Miami will advance to Louisville in the South region. So stay tuned to A Lot of Sports Talk and A Lot of SportsTalk.com. We have interviews from each of the winners here today. We talk with Greg Marshall. We also talk with Makai Mason of the Yale Bulldogs. That story is up right now. We also have interviews with Davon Reed of the Miami Hurricanes, as well as Matt Jones of the Duke Blue Devils. So once again, the madness starting, and once again, March Madness on day one does not disappoint. From the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island, this is Adeshina Koike for A Lot of SportsTalk.com.